Good day, fellow investors. Today I want to discuss a very interesting agricultural stock. If you're looking to protect yourself from whatever is going on in the world, if you go towards land, towards agricultural commodities, you know you're safe because that's the most defensive sector. So let's look at Adecoagro, a Brazilian-Argentinian play with a lot of land in Argentina that might give you that exposure to agriculture you're looking for in your portfolio. Therefore, this is a stock to watch if you're looking for something like that. The key with the company is it is really a low-cost producer of food. Okay, a little bit of a renewable energy, but starting with sugar and then now going into milk. One of the lowest cost potential producers in the world. It has 122,000 hectares owned land. It has own handling, storage, processing, positive track record of land development, low-cost production, and also sugarcane crushing capacity for ethanol and sugar. Over the past, it has been a growth story, a little bit less land growth, but since 2011 listed on the New York Stock Exchange, and there has been nothing other than growth despite whatever has been going on in the sector. Most of the plants are in Argentina, of course. They have mills, free mills, storage, and of course agricultural production. They want to mostly expand by doing organic growth, but they are also trying to acquire the biggest milk processor in Argentina. So that's also something interesting. As I said, the key is the cost, and they have the lowest cost of producing sugar in the world. So that's very competitive. No matter what goes on with the sugar prices, up, down, left or right, Adecoagro will always lead to profits and lead you to safety when you invest in it. There are their competitive advantages, low competition for land in Argentina. It's not really that you can grow something else there in place of sugar or having cattle, continuous harvest, etc., etc. Also for the dairy business, also very low cost. If they can improve the efficiencies in their new acquisition, then they can match the New Zealand cost producers and therefore have a low-cost product to export around the world, similarly as they're doing with the sugar. In the past, they did well. They generated over $300 million in cash from the transformation of land, which is also something to keep in mind, as the capital gains are $200 million. That is not bad given the current market capitalization. A little bit on the numbers. The growth has been there, good growth, 12% year per year over the last 10 years, the sales diversification, 50 something percent more on sugar, depending on where it goes, where the mix goes to ethanol. This quarter, they have increased the ethanol mix because of higher ethanol prices and low sugar prices. Ethanol was about 19 cents, sugar is about 12 cents, so it pays to produce more ethanol, and the rest is well diversified across soybean, corn, wheat, rice, dairy, and others. Also, EBITDA has been growing constantly and has reached significant numbers. What's also significant here is that corporate costs have been stable and declining, which shows that the management is not over expensive and really focused on generating wealth for shareholders, which, by the way, they also are. And the management has 6.2% in the company, and they are one of the top five shareholders. Shareholders, the leading shareholders is the Qatar Investment Authority, PGGM, Vermogensbeheer, and then we have the management. So this sounds like a great story. Let's see about the numbers behind it. The financials, you don't see that big financials because they have a lot of finance costs here that destroy the margin from EBITDA to gains, but also something very important to note that lowers the book value. So you see a price to book value that's 1.5, but it's actually much lower because a lot of their functional currencies of the subsidiaries are in the Argentinian peso or Brazilian real, which means that they are much higher in dollars, and that has an effect on the balance sheet. So the equity is 640 million to shareholders, book value $5.5, 1.57 price to book, but you have to add the land value to that. and the land value is 900 million. And if you bring it back to the balance sheet, you can see that everything that they own is 820 million. But actually the land is should be around 900 million. So there should be at least added, I would add the 500 million that they have in accumulated comprehensive losses to the calculation of the book value. So cumulative translation adjustment, 541 million. So that's something to add. That's about $4 per share plus increases in the value of land. So we are definitely at the book value of around $9.5-$10, which makes this below book value acquisition. Now, the key with this company is the cash generation, which is very high. Net cash generated from operating activities, we are at 240 million. Let's say the average will be around 200 million over the ups and downs cyclicals in sugar and ethanol. And then you have a company that is giving you $1.6 in operating cash flows. The debt is pretty high at 600 million, net is 500 million. So that's also something to calculate in depreciation. As always, there is investments. But as you own land, the free cash flow is pretty positive. This is such a diversification plan where you have to see how that fits your portfolio. If you look at the stock price since the listing, we can see it going up and down, up and down, up and down. So it is a very volatile stock. Perhaps you might buy it now that it is at 10-year lows almost, with the same thing happening in 2013, 2015, and the end of 2015. So take advantage of that if you look for exposure to land. What I have to do is compare this one with other investments in land that are there, that are possible, and then see which one is the best. So I give you an idea here, do what you can do with it, or just keep following the channel for more land related investments over time. I'm not in a rush to check those investments. We'll see. This is mostly a sugar commodity investment. I don't think it is bad now. I didn't yet calculate the returns, but that's something that I have to make a model about. This is just a preliminary research to generate idea. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.